done all this shit in 3 weeks. Look how cockeyed he looks. He's got fucking brand new windshield wipers for a busted windshield.
Well, the boy does have good hands.
Good hands. Bad taste in cars. You know, Papa, you can't polish a turd. You could scrounge through that shit pile out back. I didn't mean you could build your whole fucking car with my stuff.
What do you care? I mean, you're not doing anything with it.
Hey, don't think you got the gold key to the crapper. Nobody takes advantage of me, you understand?
What's up, YouTube? Stat44 coming in with another video. You can't polish a turd. Before I get started, I want to give a shout out to all my new subscribers, all my regular subscribers, and if you're new to my channel, go ahead, hit that subscription button in the corner of your screen, hit that notification bell as well, and you'll get all my videos sent straight to your phone or your device as soon as I put one up on YouTube. But let's get right into this video. I used the 1983 movie Christine for basically an example of what I mean by can't polish a turd. Basically, that clip was at Darnell's junkyard. The Darnell was the owner, talked to the guy Pepper about the guy that bought the car, which was Christine, and basically saying, you know, it looked like a piece of junk and this dude trying to polish it up. But this video is inspired by one of my subscribers that hit me up for a consultation last week telling me about his girlfriend. It's basically a nice looking woman. She got it going on, but inside she's kind of got some issues, and I basically told him, like, all the issues he told me about her, I was like, dude, you gonna have to cut your losses and move on. And he was like, why you say that? I was like, well, you can't polish a turd once I find out all the issues. And she had narcissistic behavior, you know, very possessive, very jealous, and it reminded me of this movie Christine. You know, I've probably seen the movie about 20 times in my life, and I never got the part until he said, you can't polish a turd. And then eventually he fixed the car up. The car looked good and looked beautiful, but the car was possessed. And it was very jealous, very demanding. It reminded me of today's people today, you know, some people live in a delusional world, some people live in a real world. But before I keep this video going, I'm going to go ahead and roll another clip of the Christine movie to show the jealousy of how the car was in the movie. And maybe you guys that haven't seen it get the idea. Maybe you guys and haven't seen the movie, go check the movie out. So let's roll the clip right now, okay?
You know, I thought girls were supposed to be jealous of other girls, not cars.
This car's a girl.
Oh, please.
Really?
Yeah. Don't.
What? Don't like me slapping your girl?
It seems like nobody likes my car these days. Oh, shit.
Okay, guys, as you can see on that part, it's a little intense. The girl almost died. She was choking, and she slapped the seat and said, "This car, you don't like me slapping your girl." And basically, the car just took over, and before you know it, the windshield stopped, and she started choking. The music started coming on, talking about we belong together, and she basically like, you know, you mess with my man because he fixed me up and all that. But basically, what I'm saying in this whole video is, guys, no matter how much you fix people up or how much you give them, if they have this delusional world and have this narcissistic behavior, you might as well just cut your losses, because at the end of the day, you know, you can't polish shit, period. You know, I hate to cuss on my videos, but at the end of the day, that's what polishing the turd mean. When people show you their behavior and, you know, they're not following your program as a woman or a man or a man or a woman or whatever you may have it, you have to cut your losses and move on, because at the end of the day, you know, you can't change nobody that don't want to be changed. And that's why I always tell you guys, plan, purpose, program. Have your plan, know your purpose, and run your program. And if people don't reciprocate to your program and who you are as a person, you have to just move on. You know, at the end of the day, I want you guys to be out there and be winners. But winners have to go, you know, have to come across losers as well in life. And you have to pick and choose who you let in your life and who you let you know, be in your life, period. So, because at the end of the day, you're going to come across losers just as much as you come across winners. But if you're a winner, you'll recognize what a loser are, what losers are. And sometimes, like I said, people come at you looking good, but their lemons inside, they're empty, they're possessive, they're narcissistic, you know. And we were just talking about this on Coach Warren's live stream. Sometimes you have to cut your losses. GMB, Grown Man Business, just did a video on let them go. You have to let a woman go sometimes. And Coach Warren just talked about it on his video too. So you have to let people go that shows you who they really are. And people will show you who they really are. They only can hold up the representative for so long. And then they'll show that possessive behavior, the jealousy, because what they want to do is they want to alienate you from the world. And it'd be about you and them. And then they put the blame on you, and they're the victim, and it's all you. That's what they want to do. That's what how narcissistic people work. They want to suck you in and make it seem like it's all your fault when things don't go their way. Same thing about the car. The car wanted the owner in the movie to be all the attention on the car. And it doesn't work like that in real life, guys. So just remember, be the best version of yourself. You know, if people are not working into your program and they're not trying to polish themselves in life, period, to be better, then realize that you can't polish a turd and move on. Because at the end of the day, you know, we want to do better for ourselves. We want to make sure we're striving in life. And that's why I always tell you guys, let's stack attack our lives. Let's stack up our lives. And let's win the first hour of the day and always put God first, guys. But this was a very short video. I just wanted to put that, you know, get that to you guys' attention. And, you know, if you haven't seen that movie, go check it out. It may help you in life and in general, just understanding, you know, a little bit. It had a little bit of everything in it. But at the end of the day, guys, I'll holler at you guys on the next video. Peace.